Margaret Mead said, we are all unique. Being all unique makes us all the same.
Inclusive design is about considering the full range of human diversity. It's both an attitude and it's a different process, and it's a stretching of our conception of the role of design or the impact of design.
The beginnings of inclusive design were in the built environment, the universal right to access to particularly public buildings and issues such as curb cuts, wheelchair ramps. As it's evolved, it's broadened in several ways. It's about products and media and services and other forms of social participation.
Inclusive design in the digital space is about creating a responsive system.
Hello.
Ni hao.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Oh, I am also very good.
Good. What is the weather like in Beijing?
Do you like wearing uniforms in school? What are you doing this summer?
The heart of interaction design is not our interaction with technology, it's our interaction with each other through technology.
You are at home or at school?
We are all at school right now.
Benny had hearing loss due to chemotherapy, and he's had hearing aids since he was 3 years old. The idea that when he is in school in the future, if he can actually be watching the professor talk without having to be facing him, I think would be really exciting.
You guys want to take a picture with us? Say cheese!
What's cheese?
These days, curb cuts extends into the digital domain, where participation in communities and cultures is digitally mediated, and so access is imperative for full civic participation.
We define disability as a mismatch between the needs of the individual and the service product or environment offered. Anyone can experience a disability. It is a common human trait to be excluded.